Hello students, welcome to RD Chemistry. Now this is a part 3 of the question for the top ranks. So let us start now. Question number 1. 1 mole of a complex compound given here CO, Cl3 and 5 amine ligands gives 3 moles of the ions in the solution. They are not given the counter ion or the ligand separately. So it will give 3 ions in the solution. 1 mole of this complex reacts with the 2 moles of the silver nitrate solution to form 2 moles of the silver chloride. The structure of the complex is. The very important technique here to find out the structure of the complex is with the silver nitrate. 2 moles are required, which means they should be 2 chloride ions outside the coordination sphere should act as the counter ions, which would react with the silver nitrate AgNO3, then that will give 2 moles of the AgCl. Okay, it's a precipitate. Now, we have got chlorides, 2 chloride in the option number C and 2 chloride in the option number D. First one and the second one cannot be the answer. Now, one more hint they are given. It will produce 3 moles of ions in the solution. Total number of ions are 3 after the dissociation. So I'll take the option number D now. Let me write on CONH3 5 times Cl. Outside the coordination sphere, we have got 2 Cl. Try to write the ionization. It will give the complex cation and the 2 chloride ions in the solution. Right? Now inside this one, we have got CO. NH3 5 times in Cl, correct? To balance the charges, 2 chlorides, 2 negative charges, this should be 2 positive charges. So altogether 1 complex ion and 2 chloride ion, altogether total number ions are is equal to 3 L. Okay, therefore answer is option number D, whereas you'll not get the 3 ions for the option number C. Okay, clear? So the answer is D L. Question number 2. The IUPAC name of the complex. This is a cobalt and NO2 is known as the nitrito. It is called as the nitrito ligand. It is ambidentate. It can be nitrito N or it can be nitrito O. When I say nitrito NO2, if I write nitrogen first, it is a nitrito N because nitrogen being the donor atom. It can be ONO also. In that case, oxygen is a donor atom. Okay, so it is nitrito N here. And NH3 is the amine ligand here. Amine ligand. Okay, so you have to go for the alphabetical order. Amine comes first, then the nitrito ligand. And outside the square bracket, we have got chlorides are the counter ions. Okay, right. How many amines are there? Pentamine. Penta comes in both the cases B and C. Pentamine. Nitrito, which one? Nitrito N. And cobalt 3 chloride. Okay. We can calculate the oxidation number, but you know that answer is option number C here. We can calculate cobalt oxidation number related to Bx plus nitrito. When I write nitrito, NO2 minus 1 charge, okay, 1 ligand, 1 charge, minus 1 charge. Then 5 amine ligand, amine is NH3, no charge on it, so it is neutral, 0. Plus 2 into chloride charges, chloride you know that minus 1, 2 into minus 1, total is 0. So when you calculate only x is equal to 3, so Roman number 3 comes here. So C is the answer. Okay, right. Coordination number CN and oxidation number of the element E. Element E is the central metal atom here. Now here they are given EN. EN stands for ethane 1,2-diamine. Ethane, this is EN. Ethane 1,2-diamine. This is the didentate ligand. Remember, this is the didentate ligand. Then there is a C2O4, actually it's 2 minus, okay. COO minus and CO minus. This is the oxalato ligand. Again, it is a didentate. So both are didentate, which are acting as the ligand. And outside this square bracket, we have got nitrito ligand. Nitrito, sorry, it's not a ligand, it's a nitrite ion. Sorry, it's a counter ion, not the ligand. Outside this square bracket, it's a counter ion, okay. Question is calculate the coordination number. What is coordination number? Coordination number is nothing but number of donor atom present. See here, in one EN, how many donor atoms are there? Nitrogen is a donor atom. Okay, because they can donate electron pair. How many donor atoms are there? Two are there. but they are given multiply by 2. So already the 4 donor atoms are there. So 4 donor atoms here in the first case plus. Then we have got oxalato, only once, oxalato. Oxygen act as the donor atom. This is didentate. So 2 donor atoms here. 2 donor atoms. Already how many donor atoms? 6 donor atoms. If there are 6 donor atoms, so therefore coordination number is equal to 6. It is there in option A and option B also. Now, next talk, they asked is the oxidation number. How to calculate oxidation number? Oxidation number of the element E, let it be X. Plus 2 into En. Now, when you see the En structure here, it is a neutral. There is no positive charge, no negative charge. So, 0. Correct? Plus 1 oxalato. Oxalato, we write C2O4, 2 minus actually. Okay? So, there are 2 negative charges. So, each oxalate is minus 2 charge. Then we have got nitrite. Nitrite, I already told you, NO2 minus. So, minus 1 charge, total should be equal to 0. So, here X is equal to 3 barate. So, therefore, oxidation number is equal to C. So, 6 and 3 should be the answer. Okay. So, the answer is option number A barate. Clear? Question number 4. In which of the following complex ion? Central metal is in a state of sp3d2 hybridization. Now, here cobalt, iron and chromium. Okay. Different central metal atoms are there. Coordination number is equal to 6. Because 6 ligand, coordination number is 6, coordination number is 6, and coordination number is 6 because all these are unidentate ligands. Okay, 6 donor atoms are there all together. Now, whenever a coordination number is equal to 6, it is a octahedral complex, right? Octahedral complex. Hybridized should be either sp3d2 or it should be d2sp3 hybridization. If it is sp3d2 hybridization, then it is the outer orbital complex. It's the outer orbital complex. That means makes the 4s, 4p and 4d. That means see all the orbitals are same shell, outermost shell. It's a generally or ns, np, nd orbitals. When I say d2sp3, it is actually outer orbital complex. Inner orbital complex. Okay. So this is the inner orbital complex. That means here it makes a 3D. I'm giving example 3D. Then 4S and 4P belonging to the outermost shell. So inner shell and outer shell is there. Both are there. Third shell and fourth shell. Inner shell, outer shell is there. So it is inner orbital complex. Remember, inner orbital complex is formed when there are strong ligands are present. And outer orbital complex form when there is a weak ligands are present. Weak ligand. Fluorido, halides are the weak field ligand. Amine, cyanido, amine are the strong ligand. Whenever strong ligands are there, electron pairing takes place according to the CFT theory. Therefore, all these have got d2sp3 hybridization. And fluorido is a weak ligand, so inner orbitals are not used as it undergoes sp3d2 hybridization. So, the answer is option number 1. Clear? Question number 5. Cuprous ion is colorless and cupric ion is colored. Now, you have to give the reason. Okay? Now, copper atomic number is 29. And copper plus 1 is called as the cuprous. You have to remember. It is known as cuprous. And copper plus 2 is called as the cupric. Remember cupric. Lower valency us, higher valency ic. So it is a 29. So it is a 3d10 and 4s1. So it has got exceptional electronic configuration. Okay. Now, next one. So 3d10 and 4s0 here. Here it is a 3d9 and 4s. Okay. 4s0 here. Right. Now, here, in the case of 3D, there are no unpaired electrons, 0. In case of 3D9, if you write down the electronic configuration, there are 5 types of d orbital, correct? So, 9 electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So, 1, okay, unpaired electron is there. Remember, whenever unpaired electrons are there, according to CFT, they can go to the excited state, okay, according to CFT. They can show the colors. If there is an unpaired electron, at least one unpaired electron, it is always colored. Okay, so In case of cupra, there are no unpaired electrons, so it is colorless. So cupra's ion has got completely filled d orbital, whereas the cupric ion has incompletely filled d orbital. So there are unpaired electrons in the cupric. So the answer is option number B. Right? Clear? Next one. The magnetic moment of the transition metal ion is square root of 15 Bm. Bm stands for Bohr magneton. Therefore, number of unpaired electron present in the metal atom is. So, how to calculate the magnetic moment using spin-only formula? So, mu is equal to square root of n into n plus 2 in terms of Bohr magneton. N stands for the number of unpaired electron. Okay, mu is the magnetic moment. Okay, Bm stands for the Bohr magneton. Okay. Now, mu, suppose n is equal to 1 unpaired electron, then you can write square root of 1 into 1 plus 2, which is equal to square root of 3, okay, Bohr magneton. Suppose n is equal to 2, then I can write square root of 2 into 2 plus 2, this is equal to 4 into 2, square root of 8 it becomes. Then n is equal to 3, then it is square root of 3 into 3 plus 2, which is equal to 5 into 3, square root of 15. You can go on writing like this, okay. Therefore, how many unpaired electrons are there? Should be 3 unpaired electrons. Therefore, answer is option number A. Clear? Question number 7. Cerium. Okay. 58 atomic number. Is the most important member of the lanthanoid. Which of the following statement about the cerium is incorrect? Okay. So, lanthanoids, so they are given about the oxidation states are given, correct? About the oxidation state, all these options, correct? So, then remember, lanthanoids have got plus 3 state and lanthanoid got plus 4 common oxidation state. These are the state, generally, general common oxidation state. And lanthanum plus 3 is the most stable state, most stable in the aqueous solution. Okay? So, they have option number A is a correct statement. 3 and 4 are correct. Cerium 4 is an oxidizing agent. Cerium plus 4 is an oxidizing agent. If it is an oxidizing agent, it oxidizes other substances but undergoes reduction to give cerium plus 3, and cerium plus 3 is most stable. So it can act as the oxidizing agent. Correct statement. But you have to find out the incorrect statement. The plus 4 oxidation of cerium is not shown in the solution. So plus, previously told that cerium plus 4 is an oxidizing agent. Oxidizing agent exists. That means generally, solution prepared in water, water acts as a ligand. So, it's oxidizing agent. Solution exists. So, plus 4 is known. They are given not known. So, this will be a wrong statement. So, for this question, answer is C. Then, plus 3 state of cerium is more stable than the plus 4 state is also correct statement. So, answer for this question is option number C. Clear? Question number 8. Which of the following compound is not chiral? Not chiral means this is optically inactive compound. Optically inactive compound. Okay. Which means that there is no chiral carbon. Chiral carbon illa. Chiral carbon illa. Okay. What do you mean by chiral carbon? Chiral carbon means the given carbon atom chiral only when it is attached to four different groups. For example, P, Q, R, Mathias. Four different groups. It can be atom, it can be groups around it. Okay. Clear? So, they should not be the carbon which should be attached to four different groups. Let me take the first option. 1 chlorobutane. Butane means altogether how many carbon atom? 4 carbon atom. 1 chloro. Chlorine is here. Remaining valence should be satisfied by what? Hydrogen. Correct? Okay. So, this is one of the simplest structure in among the options given here. So, can you see anywhere here? 1 carbon attached to 4 different groups. Here, 2 hydrogens are similar. No. Here, 2 hydrogen similar, no. Here, 2 hydrogen similar, no. Here, 3 hydrogen similar, no. So, none of the carbon atoms are asymmetric or chiral carbons. So, compound is optically inactive. So, first one is the answer. You can check for other options. In other option, at least one carbon will have the 4 different groups attached to it. Groups should not repeat on the same carbon atom. Okay? Right? Answer is E. Clear? Question number 9. Which of the following is the correct order of decrease SN2 reactivity? Remember, SN1 order and SN2 order reactivity, alkyl halide. So, your tertiary greater than secondary greater than primary greater compared to methyl halides. Here, reverse order. Methyl halide comes first, then the primary, then the secondary, then the tertiary. Okay. So, you have to go for this one. Primary, secondary, tertiary. So, where is that? Here it is. Correct? This is the primary alkalalite, secondary alkalalite, tertiary alkalalite. Okay. So the C2HXR, correct? So halogen attached to a primary carbon atom. What do you mean by primary carbon? It should be attached to only one carbon, R, directly. This is a primary. I want to make secondary. Secondary means there should be one more R. This is a secondary. I want to make this a tertiary. Remove this hydrogen. This is a tertiary, correct? So the answer is option number A. First one is the answer. Clear? Next question. On heating mixture of two alkalalites with the sodium metal in dry ether, 2-methylpropane was formed. The alkalalite is. Suppose we make use of the Wurtz reaction, RxRx. It reacts with sodium metal. You know that it will give R and R, correct? Now, what they are given is, they are given the product. You have to predict the starting material. So what you can do is, if there is a molecule like this, break the molecule, introduce halogen like this. So RxRx is formed. Here we get two methyl propane, carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, propane, 2 methyl, on second carbon methyl group is there. Remaining valence is CH3, here it is a CH, you know, it is CH3, correct? Break anywhere, we can break anywhere, okay? We can break anywhere like this, okay? If we break anywhere, you're going to get the same structure. So introduce halogen like this. So what I'm going to do is CH3, here it is X, it is CH3, or which can be written as this as CH3, CHX, okay, and CH3. One more molecule, second molecule is CH3X. Since they are given halogen, let me take halogen here, okay. So Cl let me take and Cl let me take. So this is a 2-chloropropane, this is a chloromethane. So 2-chloropropane and chloromethane. Option is A. Clear? Right? Yeah, students, I am going to continue all these series, part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, something like this. I am going to continue, okay? Questions for top ranks. If you like this video, please do subscribe and share, and please write down the comments. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.